My name's Lee Kemp, and I'm a filmmaker based in the UK. So me and some of my friends have decided to get together and make a short film. But the first thing we wanted to do was get all of our kit and shoot some test footage. And as you can see, I think it turned out pretty well.
Hola amigos, bienvenidos a Star Losers, el primer talk show sobre Star Wars de América Latina. Bueno, nuestro amigo Lee ya se encargó de presentarse solo, así que los invito a que veamos juntos la entrevista que le hicimos donde nos cuenta todos los detalles de su proyecto y principalmente cómo podemos ayudar para que se haga realidad. ¿Vamos a verla?
Hello.
Hello, how are you?
I'm good, thank you.
First, let's talk about your relationship with Star Wars.
I'm 42, so I'm quite old. So I remember obviously watching A New Hope as a kid, just relentlessly on VHS video. The first one that I was able to see in the cinema was Jedi, and I just remember I lived in a tiny village in a place called Yorkshire in the UK, and you know, it was not just my first Star Wars film in the cinema, it was the end, it was the last one. My best friend at school was American, so my dad was in the Air Force, and he was the son of the US Air Force liaison officer, so he had all of these toys that you just couldn't get in the UK. You know, they just didn't exist, and because they had loads more money than me, he had loads of them, and I can't get my hands on these things, and I have all these memories. Like, I remember the so there was the TV commercial for the speeder bikes, which I remember in the commercial you would they were flying them through the table legs of the dining room table, and then you'd kind of smash it into one and you press a thing on the back and it would explode. Like, and that was just like, that was my whole life as a kid. Like, just completely obsessed with Star Wars, and because I've had this idea for this kind of film for, like, since I was a teenager, long before I ever got into making films, which has only been about kind of the last 10-12 years. And so I now feel I'm at a point where I have the experience, I understand how filmmaking works, how to tell a story, and it was just, it just kind of came together at the right time, really. And it felt, I was having a conversation a couple of years ago in a bar with my regular cinematographer that I use all the time, and he was talking about how he'd met up with this guy who happened to be, had previously been a member of the UK garrison of the 501st. And so he was saying, you know, met this guy, has access to loads of costumes and stuff. And he was talking about doing a Star Wars fan film with, you know, his friend. I said, well, I've had this idea for years and years and years now. And I kind of pitched my idea to him, and he went, dude, that is way better than what we were thinking about. We should do that. So I'd been working with a writer on another project, and I went and pitched the idea to her. I said, would you be interested in writing this for me? She said, yeah, I'd love to. So then the original guy from the UK garrison heard about this, and we went and had a meeting. And when I first met this guy, who's in our video, when I very first met him, he turned up with 20 pages of sketches, just stuff that he'd drawn, and he got, in fact, I've got some.
Okay.
I had never met James in my life. This was our very first meeting. I'd never pitched him the project, you know, and he had just, you know, pages and pages and pages of concept art, of things that he, you know, different ideas that he was messing around with. There's much more of a kind of Knights Templar feel about it, you know, that kind of stuff. So you know, so it's a slightly more kind of rogue sort of thing.
It kind of remind me to the Clone Wars. I don't know if you saw the animated series.
Yeah, some. Yeah.
Yeah, it reminds me a little bit to that.
Yeah, so it's so that was kind of how it came about, really. We, you know, it was a conversation in a bar.
Okay.
You know, as these things often are.
That's the way to start things, right? What about the story? What can you tell me about the story of the film?
So our story takes place a long time after Jedi, but before Force Awakens. So after Jedi, there was a whole bunch of remnants of the Imperial fleet became the Imperial Remnant and disappeared, and so and eventually becomes the First Order. So what we have is, this is a very English term, but it's what I'm describing as a gap year Jedi. So what I mean by that, she's coming to the end of her training, but she's very powerful. A bit arrogant, a bit impetuous, thinks she's better than the stuff she's being asked to do. So as a last ditch attempt to get her where she needs to be, she's sent off to what we think is an abandoned planet. And while she's there, and she's just doing mundane tasks, so she's doing soil samples and just really boring things, and she hates it. The First Order arrive, and they're looking for something on the planet. So she's finally got the fight that she's looking for. But it turns out there are other people from history on the planet,
okay,
who she has to contend with. And then she realizes what the First Order have come for is really important. She has to get off the planet really quickly. But she started a fight that she doesn't know that she can finish.
Okay.
So I'm very excited
so
about it.
It's a very ambitious project. Sounds like that, at least.
Yeah.
Okay, let's talk a little bit about the production. Are you shooting there? Is everything going to be shoot on set? Is there any outside shooting?
So we are anticipating a 5-day shoot. And that's because the script is about 16 pages long, which equates to about 16 minutes of film. So one of the key things is just giving ourselves time to get it right. So almost all of it takes place in a forest, because obviously it's Star Wars, there's always a forest.
Okay.
You
sure.
know, so, but we also have some, there's a few interiors as well, but I think it will be four days in the forest, 1 day of interiors.
Okay.
We found it very hard to put the visual effects budget together. But we have a university here who are doing they have a visual effects degree.
Mm-hmm.
So the final year students on that degree are doing our film as their project.
Okay, that's
so
cool.
But also, since we've launched the campaign, I've had a guy from, I think he's in Montreal, has got in touch. So he's currently working on Fantastic Beasts, and he was on Gravity. He's helping us out. I've had a couple of other people get in touch. So the visual effects side of things is just, yeah, mind-blowing. Ambitious.
Yes, as the whole project, I mean. How many people is involved? Cast, crew?
There are three main actors in the cast. We are expecting 8 to 10 stormtroopers, hopefully, that we will make look like 100. And in terms of crew, just because we're doing this properly, it's about 34, I think.
Oof.
I've been working on this for nearly 3 years now, so by the time we come to actually shoot, it's got to be right, you know.
Yeah.
It's and that's why, you know, it's going to cost us over £1,000 just to feed everybody for that week. So, you know,
yeah,
it's ambitious.
I understand.
Yeah.
You are getting a lot of help from a lot of people that started when you started the Kickstarter campaign. So
yeah,
I think you may even be able to do the film even if you don't raise the money through the campaign.
We will make the film whether or not we raise the money. But the film we'll make if we raise the money will be different to the film we make if we don't, obviously. We're trying to raise about £28,000, which is a lot. Where I am at the moment, I need 738 people to pledge £25.
Yeah.
You know, that's basically where I am. So we've got a new pledge that we're going to launch next week, which is much more okay. to do with the visual effects.
Okay.
I think my favorite pledge we have is at the £50 level, which is quite a lot, but we're writing a book about the making of the film. Mm-hmm. You know, if you're interested in the process of making a film like this, it would be interesting. If you know someone who loves Star Wars, it would make a good gift for them at Christmas. And it's because we have so much good photography already, and we haven't even made the film. So it will be jam-packed with images and concept art and visual effects and Kickstarter tips and all that kind of stuff, because this is my first Kickstarter campaign, so I've learned a lot about how to do this as well.
The last thing I want to ask you, and we are done, is if you want to say like a message or something to the people that are watching us to make them support your project.
I just want to say, first of all, thank you to you, Diego, for having me on. I think you're doing great work there. Just for everybody watching the podcast, first of all, thanks for watching. We've been working on this for 3 years. The team are doing it with such love and care and attention. And we're at the stage now where we just need people's help. People think with Kickstarter, it's a donation, you know, it's like a charity. It's not, it's a pledge. You're buying something from us. So check out the campaign. Whatever you can give would be absolutely immense. If you can't give anything yourself, share the campaign with people that you think would get something out of it. And when we do get there, come back and we'll do this again when the film's ready to go.
One of the things that caught my attention was the quality of the pictures you post in your Instagram account.
Yeah.
It feels like Star Wars, and it you can feel the work behind the images.
Yeah. Thank you.
The energy. I wish you the best luck.
Thank you.
All our energy is there with you. Trying to make this done.
Perfect. Thank you. Thanks, Diego. Have a good weekend.
Okay. Same to you, Lee.
Okay. I will speak
soon. Have a great weekend. Bye.
Bye.
Amigos, ¿quién podría filmar un corto de Star Wars, no? Los invitamos a visitar la página del proyecto en la plataforma Kickstarter. Vamos a dejar el link en la descripción del video para ver si podemos entre todos colaborar con un granito de arena para que esto salga adelante. Suscríbanse a nuestro canal, síganos en las redes sociales, en Instagram @starlosers, en Facebook también y en Twitter @starlosers_sw. Que la fuerza los acompañe y nos vemos pronto.